I'm Lee Buckner, your economics instructor. And in this video, I'm gonna give you a brief overview of the circular flow diagram, sometimes called the circular flow model. So, circular flow diagram is a simple illustration which shows how households and firms interact with each other. The two primary ways that we're gonna think about households and firms interacting is in a product market and a factor or resource market. So first, let's talk about that word market. What I mean by market is an exchange of value at agreed upon terms. So first, it's a verb, right? When you have a transaction taking place, that's a market. For example, let's talk about product markets first. An example of a product market could be a person going into Best Buy and buying a television, right? So Best Buy, a firm, offers televisions for sale. Say they have a TV for sale for $500. You, representing a household, could walk into that firm's place of business, accept their offer of $500 for that TV, and then take the TV back to your house. That exchange, when you give the firm money and the firm in exchange gives you the good or service, is a product market. The way we think about households and firms interacting in our circular flow diagram is called flows. So in a product market, like say when you go buy a TV from Best Buy, money flows out of your household and into a firm. That's here. And products, goods and services, flow out of the firm and into your household. I'm gonna label that product with a G/S, meaning goods and services, right? So that's the main way that most people think about households and firms interacting. But it's not the only way. You see, firms also need to get resources in order to make those goods and services. So in the circular flow diagram, we think about households as being the owners of resources. And they will sometimes sell those resources to firms. Most common way to think about this is going to work, right? Say you work at the television factory, right? The television factory needs workers to make the TVs that then they can then sell to other households. But if you go to work, which is to say you sell your labor to a household, they use that, they sell that labor to a firm, they can use that labor to make the television. So in a resource, sometimes known as a factor market, we see firms buying resources like labor, and when they buy them, they are giving money for them to the households. This is what it looks like for these flows. Resources flow out of households and into firms. The most common resource that's transacted here would be labor. And then payment for those resources goes from the firm over to households. You might think about this as getting a wage for your labor. And now you think about why households might want to engage in that transaction, why you might want to sell a lot of your time. Well, if you want to buy things like televisions and houses and electricity, you've got to get that money from somewhere, right? You've got to get that income from somewhere. The way most people get it is they sell their labor or some sort of resource they own to a firm. Then firms use those resources to create goods and services that they'll then sell to other households. And thinking about that interaction of households and firms in both resource markets and in product markets is our circular flow